Manila's defense chief denounces China's alleged attempts to deflect attention away from its illegal activities in the exclusive economic zone of the Philippines. Bianca Dava reports.
Defense Secretary Gilberto Teodoro Jr. on Tuesday urged Filipinos not to lose sight of China's illegal activities in the West Philippine Sea as more details of a supposed gentleman's agreement unravel. In an open letter, Teodoro reminded Filipinos not to fall into the trap of refocusing the debate, which he said is part of Chinese propaganda on the issue. Former presidential spokesperson Harry Roque earlier claimed that former President Rodrigo Duterte and Chinese President Xi Jinping agreed during Duterte's term to maintain the status quo in Ayungin Shoal, where the BRP Sierra Madre was ran aground. Roque believes the Philippines would lose Ayungin Shoal if it keeps a hardline stance against China. He criticized President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., claiming the chief executive still does not have a clear policy on China 2 years into office. For Roque, the Duterte administration had a better foreign policy, being able to maintain BRP Sierra Madre without attracting China's attention.
If we persist in what we're doing, China will just bar us from Ayungin altogether. And, you know, mark my word, I said it in your program. If we continue with this course of action, we will be forced to retrieve our soldiers because they will starve to death.
Roque suggests decommissioning the BRP Sierra Madre, the country's lone Navy outpost in the West Philippine Sea, to ease tensions.
Make it into a Coast Guard vessel so that it will not be a militarized vessel. And therefore, if we decommission it, then perhaps China will allow it to be repaired. Now, I do not know if China will or will not, but certainly that will make us conform with UNCLOS. Coast Guard is considered a civil vessel, and it could also be armed for all intents and purposes.
But former Navy officer and Senator Antonio Trillanes IV warns decommissioning the BRP Sierra Madre would be a big mistake.
That's a trap. Okay, and that's what China wants. Okay, remember, kaya hindi ginagalaw yung BRP Sierra Madre, kahit theoretically, kayang-kayang i-overrun ng PLA yan, ng Chinese Armed Forces, but since a commissioned ship siya ng Philippine Navy, it may trigger the Mutual Defense Treaty. So the moment you decommission that, then it's now vulnerable, no? Pwede na silang iharas ng iharas until magalisan yan.
Trillanes added, Roque's statement that Manila would lose Ayungin Shoal only supports Beijing's narrative.
That's fear-mongering. And I think that's the narrative that China wants to spread. No? And it's ironic that Filipinos are spreading that Chinese propaganda. Hindi lang si Harry Roque, si Duterte mismo, no? During the Duterte administration, ganun sila. Ano sinabi ni Duterte? Gawin nyo na lang Philippine province of China.
Meanwhile, National Security Advisor Eduardo Anyo and his United States counterpart Jake Sullivan have reaffirmed the alliance between Manila and Washington following the recent incidents of harassment by China in the West Philippine Sea. In a statement, the National Security Council said Anyo spoke on the phone with Sullivan on Monday, with the American official assuring the U.S.'s ironclad commitment to the Philippines under the two countries' mutual defense treaty. The two officials also look forward to the upcoming Japan-Philippines-U.S. Trilateral Leaders Summit in Washington, D.C. next week. Bianca Dava, ABS-CBN News.
The lawyer of expelled lawmaker Arnulfo Teves Jr. says political asylum and other legal remedies are still on the table despite his client being under Timor-Leste.
Masama connection.
Here's a look back at what has happened so far after the arrest of Teves.
Yes, I'm here, pero masama.
The National Bureau of Investigation Director Medardo de Lemos arrived in the country with his team from Timor-Leste on Sunday. He says they will return there once the Timorese court decides on the Philippine government's deportation request for former Negros Oriental Congressman Arnulfo Teves Jr.
Napakalaking bagay na pinuntahan natin sila. Kasi kung papel lang ang pag-uusapan, ay antagal na ng red notice list na yon.
According to De Lemos, while Timor-Leste President Jose Ramos Horta accommodated the request to arrest Teves, the process leading up to the arrest, including visiting him in jail, was not easy.
sa totoo niyan, yung paghuli sa kanya, kaya drone ang kinuha doon, pakiusap din na mabigyan tayo ng footage na yon. Officially, ayaw nila. Kasi ayaw din nung management nung golf course na magkaroon ng incident doon.
The NBI's investigation showed Tevez has previously visited Timor-Leste. He also went to Australia and Cambodia when authorities started looking for him. De Lemos declined to answer if Tevez had any influence over some Timorese officials.
Ayaw kong sagutin ng tuwiran yan kasi babalik pa tayo doon. Hindi maganda ang magiging posisyon natin. Very factual lang naman tayo. Nahirapan kami, hindi nahirapan lang. Karoon lang ng konting skirmishes, yung normal siguro na maging emotional sila. Emotional din kami kasi may objective tayo sa kanila. Mayroon din silang proseso.
Justice Secretary Boying Remulla had previously accused Tevez of being protected by warlords, which his lawyer denied.
Sabi ni Remulla a few months back that there are foreign warlords helping out Tevez. So, nasan yung foreign warlords na yun? Eh, ba't puro Filipinong nakita? These people are lying to their teeth.
Topacio also clarified that Tevez does not have a case in Timor-Leste, which is why he was able to freely move around and play golf.
He's not a fugitive in Timor-Leste, he's an applicant for political asylum. That's why he is openly moving about. Yun ang hindi nila maintindihan at Mr. Tevez has committed no violation of any law in Timor-Leste.
The DOJ opposes the plan of the Tevez camp to bring his case before the United Nations Commission on Human Rights, alleging the cases filed against the former lawmaker was government persecution. The DOJ spokesperson Mico Clavano asserts that the multiple murder, attempted murder, and frustrated murder cases against Tevez will have to go through the Philippine justice system. For now, the Philippine Embassy in Dili will monitor the trial of Tevez. The trial may take up to 40 days before a decision is made. Nico Bawa, ABS-CBN News.
The new Philippine National Police Chief rules out a revival of the Duterte administration's war against illegal drugs. He also sees no need for another reshuffle of police officers. This report from Raya Capulong.
The Philippines Top Cop sees no need to revive the war on drugs, which was a hallmark of the previous administration. This statement by newly appointed BNP Chief General Romel Francisco Marbil appears to repudiate the announcement of Davao City Mayor Sebastian Duterte, who adopted his father's anti-drug campaign. For Marbil, this course of action is not necessary to achieve a drug-free community. He also says he will not order police personnel to increase the number of drug-related arrests.
Wala po kaming gera dito Hindi ito gera na kailangan mo . It's more of talaga, paano natin mabababa yung crimes natin based on sa mga parameters natin. I don't want to say na may drug war. Parang gera na naman kami.
The deaths from Davao City operations against illegal drugs since the mayor's declaration remain at 7. Several police personnel have since been relieved to give way to investigations over the drug-related deaths. Marbil also rules out a revamp in the PNP. Just last year, the PNP underwent a major overhaul after Interior Secretary Benhur Abolos Jr. asked for the resignation of top PNP officials amid government's probe into the possible involvement of senior officers in the illegal drug trade. Back then, President Marcos accepted the courtesy resignation of 18 third-level officers of the PNP. Several police officers were also charged with drug-related offenses.
No, I do not do that. Kasi pagka ginawa mo yung reshuffle na yun, magiging unstable yung unit Wala namang kasalanan yung mga police natin to reshuffle. Lahat naman to ang ginagawa na namin, we will be coming with a better parameter for them to be measured. Kung hindi mo kaya ito, then we will give you a chance to improve. Kung hindi mo talaga kaya, then we will get a better commander.
To weed out scalawags in uniform and improve the performance of their personnel, Marbil prefers raising their standards instead of implementing internal cleansing.
Kailangan lang natin, hindi po internal cleansing, we just come up with a better parameter, better measurements for our policemen na dapat itong standard na habulin nyo. Kung cope with the standard, then we will anyway teach you how.
One major change, he says, is banning police personnel from using cell phones while on duty.
This is my first and last warning. No cell phone during duties. We need patrol. Pagka nahuli ka namin ng cell phone, there will be no forgiveness.
Cybercrime is also a major concern for Marbil, who plans to hire experts and invest in facilities to improve their capacity to combat this growing threat. Raya Capulong, ABS-CBN News.